Many Aboriginal people have fled from the Northern Territory to seek respite from federal restrictions on welfare and alcohol consumption. But for many towns in neighbouring South Australia, this cross-border influx has swamped local social services and communities are struggling to cope. Amanda Ho travelled to the APY lands and filed this report.
Cooper Pedy, a desert town roughly halfway between Adelaide and Alice Springs. It's home to Glenys Dodd, a local Indigenous health worker from the Umana Judica Health Clinic.
Do the morning medication run.
Servicing the nearby Aboriginal community of Umana is just one of the clinic's activities. For those in need, a shower, a fresh set of clothes and a free breakfast are also part of the daily offering. But it's a service under pressure. The 2007 intervention in neighbouring Northern Territory imposed welfare and alcohol restrictions on Indigenous communities there. This triggered a cross-border influx of Aboriginal people into South Australia.
The next party town was Cooper Pedy, so we caught the brunt of all the transients coming down specifically to drink, which caused another set of problems.
Steve Baines is the mayor of Cooper Pedy. He says the huge number of new arrivals has left South Australian towns like his struggling to cope.
So it caused homelessness, it caused abuse, and it caused a huge strain on the resources of the town and in particular the government agencies that are tasked to look after those people. We were just not prepared for it. We certainly weren't given the resources to cope with it.
A gap between need and service capacity that's left the Umana Health Service near breaking point. In the financial year from 2007, the service saw just over 3,500 people. But 12 months later, the numbers more than doubled. So far this year, nearly 10,000 people have walked through the clinic doors.
A lot of the people come with no money, no accommodation. You know, they're sleeping down the creeks. And it also puts a lot of pressure on local families, which they have to, they're obligated to give a bed.
Desperate for help, the Umana and Cooper Pedy councils submitted a report to the Intervention Review Board requesting extra funding to cope with the population increase. But they say their cries for help fell on deaf ears. In a statement from the Department of Indigenous Affairs about the report, a spokesperson stated that the movement between communities and towns is not new. Communities such as Cooper Pedy and Port Augusta have traditionally experienced a seasonal increase of people travelling from remote communities for many years. Many locals allege, though, that this position is simply a convenient justification for the lack of extra funding from the government. Frustrated, they've given up applying for extra financial support. But despite the setbacks, the health workers are determined to continue their mission. For Glenys, it's the end of another long day with little respite expected anytime soon.
And the federal government has just introduced new legislation in Parliament to extend current alcohol restrictions and increase penalties for grog running.